This video is about 8 really important steps which every entrepreneur should integrate in their business if they want to be successful. My name is Tineke Rensen and I will give you a little training about the blueprint for a successful business makeover. And at the end of this short training, you will know exactly what the 8 steps are and how you can implement them in your business and how you can make them work for you, yourself as a business owner, and how to implement it in your business. Now, I made a study about entrepreneurship for many years. And right now, I'm the CEO of Powerful Business Academy. I help entrepreneurs and business owners to get the full potential out of themselves and out of their business. And I've been doing that for 7 years. And before that, I used to have a business, international travel agency in outdoor sports and survival activities throughout Europe. So I have been in business quite long. I have had to face many challenges. I had a lot of successes. And because I made this study, I do want to share my tips with you so you won't make the same mistakes and you will have a shortcut to success, personal and business success. So I wrote a book about this. And every chapter is about one of the chapters here in the Business Makeover Blueprint. And we start with mindset. So what does mindset contain? Well, first of all, you have to be really aware about what your thoughts and your feelings are. And you might think, well, why is this so important? Because, and this is one of the other chapters, it's important because how you feel and what your thoughts are, they determine the kind of action you make. And the kind of action you make determines eventually your result. So your thoughts and your feelings are responsible for your business result and for your personal result. Now, the next thing is imagination. Can you imagine stuff before you even start doing it? Can you imagine what it will look like? Can you imagine what it will feel like? Can you imagine how you want it to be? Because everything starts with imagination. First, you have to see it in your mind's eye, and then you can start doing it and acting it and getting the kind of results that you want. But first, you have to see the results that you like. And excuses, you know, we all have excuses. And they are always true for you, because they reflect your thoughts, your feelings, they reflect your behavior. They reflect your inner world. They reflect your beliefs about yourself, about the actions you are going to take. So excuses, they never help you. So just try to get rid of all excuses, because, you know, for example, Thomas Edison, he tried over and over and over and over and over to create the light bulb. And I think it cost him 999 times, which is quite a lot, before he finally succeeded. So would he have given up the 998th time? Maybe somebody else would have invented it, but he would have been a failure. So if failure is not an option, there are no excuses. And then, especially for business owners, your money blueprint or your money mindset is very important. How you do money is how you do everything. Money is a very, very good metaphor. If you ignore the money in your business, which I know many entrepreneurs do, although some of them are money driven, but they don't have the tools how to manage their money. And I know specifically women, they have often not a very good relationship with money. Consider money being a friend of you. Would it be with you if you treated your friend exactly as money, or if you would think about it exactly the same as money? Maybe not. If you think, you know, I don't like it, or, you know, I don't understand how to do it, all these kind of stuff. If If you would say this to a friend, your friend wouldn't stick, neither does money. And then there's the conscious and the subconscious. We believe that all the decisions we make, we are fully aware of all the facts and all the figures and all the circumstances. Well, I have to disappoint you, because we are mainly driven by subconscious beliefs and subconscious emotions and feelings. And a lot of the times they don't support us very well. So 90% of every decision that you make is driven by subconscious stuff from inside. And it can be something from when you're a child. It can be something you would have heard or you've experienced. But who's going to tell you that an experience you had in the past will be a blueprint for the experience you are creating now? It can be totally different. But because you had a bad experience, it won't mean you will have a bad experience again. But because of a bad experience, our actions, our thoughts and our feelings are different. All the mindset stuff is so important when you are an entrepreneur. Then there's the energy. You know, if you look at electricity, you cannot see it. You know, when you put the plug in the plug hole, there will be electricity. Or when you switch the switch from the light, there will be light. So you don't have to be able to see it, but you will see the results. And that's the same with your own energy. You know, you feel maybe bad, or you feel tired or stuff like that. And whatever your feelings are, it does determine your outcome. So energy is something we do not see, but we can feel. And because we do not see, it doesn't mean it's not there. And energy is a vibration. And everything around us has a vibration. Other people, stuff, situations, they all have vibration. So what is your vibration like? And what kind of situations or circumstances match with your vibration? You have to be really aware of your own energy, which is vibration. Then there's the action. What kind of action do you take? Do you take positive, determined, confident action? Or do you take action because you need to, but you're not really sure about the outcome? There is definitely a difference in those two ways of taking action and towards the results you're getting. And then last but not least, there's trust. Do you have faith? Can you trust that even if you don't know the outcome yet, or you even might not know how to grow or get to the outcome, that there will be an outcome for you? And that whatever outcome there will be, that it will be the best outcome for you right there at that moment. And it might not be the outcome that you wish for. But then you have feedback and you have new insights and you can evaluate and re-evaluate and take other action. So can you trust the process? Can you trust that no matter what happens, it's always right, even if you don't like it? Because if you can, you will get much faster results. And you feel less stress, you feel a lot better during the process. And I guarantee you that many coincidental things will happen. So this was video number one from the series of 8 videos about the 8 steps of the blueprint for a successful business makeover, which helps business owners to grow to their full potential. So please make sure you watch the other 7 videos too, because they will be full with a lot of extra tips and information about how to grow your business to your full potential.